Hello students, today we will see the practical number 10 from the EEM subject. So the aim of the practical is 2 wattmeters method for power measurement. So in this practical we have to measure the active power by using 2 wattmeter method. As we know that there are 3 methods for the power measurement: 1 wattmeter, 2 wattmeter and 3 wattmeter method. So we will use the 2 wattmeter method. So for this type of method, it is suitable for the 3 phase 3 wire system. Also it can be used for star and delta system. And one more advantage of the system is this type of method can be used for the balance and unbalanced load. So this is most important method. How it will be conducted, we will see today. Let us move towards the circuit diagram for the 2 wattmeter method. So I am taking the 2 wattmeters W1 and W2. First wattmeter I am connecting in the R phase and second wattmeter I am connecting in the B phase. Here I am taking the star connected resistive load bank. With respect to this load, we have to connect the 2 wattmeters, voltmeter and ammeter. So how we will connect? So from the R phase, R, Y and B phase, in between the 2 phases, that means in between R and Y, I am connecting the voltmeter, and in series with the R phase I am connecting 1 ammeter to measure the current. So from the R point, R phase, I am connecting the positive terminal of the voltmeter. From this positive terminal of the voltmeter, again I am connecting the ammeter positive. This ammeter negative will connect to the M terminal of the wattmeter, that is the current coil. This L terminal of the wattmeter will be connected to the R phase of the load. Next, M and this C terminal of the pressure coil will always short circuited. So these are connected to each other, and this V terminal will be connected to the Y phase. Next one is the negative terminal of the voltmeter will also connected to the Y phase. So this is connection of first wattmeter. This is our wattmeter 1. Next one, wattmeter 2. Wattmeter 2 is connected in phase B. So the B phase is connected directly to the M terminal of the wattmeter 2. Next, L terminal of the load, it will be connected towards the B phase. So it is connected to the B phase. Next, again same, M and C terminals are connected short circuited, and this V terminal of the second wattmeter will be again connected to the Y phase. And this Y phase is connected to the load terminal of the Y phase. So this is the load terminal of the Y phase. So with respect to this load, we have to take the readings of W1 and W2. So as we know that for the resistive type of load, the wattmeter W1 and wattmeter 2, it should show the same readings. We will see in the practical how it will show the readings equal or not. We will do the connections for the practical setup. So from this 3 phase autotransformer, we are taking the 3 terminals R, Y and B, and from this we have to connect the ammeter, voltmeter and 2 wattmeters, which has the same full scale deflection 2500, and we are connecting the resistive type of load, 3 phase resistive load bank. So from starting, we will connect the from R phase. So from this R phase, I am connecting the voltmeter positive. So this R phase will connect to the voltmeter positive. From this voltmeter positive, I am connecting the ammeter positive terminal. From this ammeter negative, we will connect the wattmeter first M terminal. From this wattmeter first, it will goes to the C terminal, because we know that M and C terminals are always short circuited. So this L terminal will be connected to the load. So 3-phase load bank will be connected to the load bank. So next one. Is the Y phase. With the help of Y phase, we are connecting just VV terminals. So this Y terminal will be connect to the negative of the voltmeter. And from this negative terminal of the voltmeter, we have to connect the V terminal of the wattmeter 1 or 2. We can connect any one of the wattmeter. Next one, I am connecting the B phase. From this B phase, directly we will connect the M terminal of the wattmeter. Again same, from this wattmeter, M terminal and C terminal will get short circuited. For this load, it will be connected to the V load. So the load bank terminal B, it will be connect to the wattmeter 2, because we are connecting second wattmeter in phase with the B. So this L goes to the B terminal. Next, we have to short circuit this V and V terminal. So this V and V get short circuited, and we have to connect the Y phase, this Y phase, Y load bank towards the V terminal. I am connecting this Y phase to the V terminals. This wattmeter first V and second wattmeter V are connected each other, and I am connecting the Y phase towards the V terminal. From this V, we are connecting the negative of the voltmeter, and from this one, we are connecting the Y phase. So it will be our Y phase completed. So as per this type of connections, we have to take the readings. From here, we are giving the 3-phase AC supply. With the help of this 3-phase auto transformer, we can give the 3-phase voltage 440 volt. Next one, we have to take the readings of our voltmeter and ammeter as per the load, and as per the power consumption, we have to take the two readings of the wattmeters. So this one is our wattmeter 1 and this will be our wattmeter 2. Okay, let us start. So I am giving the supply, and we are giving as a 415 voltage. So the voltage, it will be equals to 415 volt. Corresponding to this one, we have to measure the current. So we can see here, current, it will be equals to 2 ampere, because we are selecting the range, it will be equals to 10. So as per this 10 range, here we are taking the low range, it will be equals to 2 ampere. So current, it will be equals to 2 ampere. And similarly, we have to measure the readings of wattmeter. So W1, it will be equals to 810 or 800. Here it will be equals to 810. And here we can see the readings of wattmeter. And similarly, for the resistive load, our wattmeter 2 also gives the same reading as a W1. So here we can see it also shows the 810 watt. So wattmeter 2 also shows the 810 watt. So I am increasing the load of the 3 phases R, Y and B. So as we get increases the load, power consumption will get also increases, and current will get also increases. So we will take the readings. So again, we can see here the current will be equals to 2.5 4 ampere. So current it will be equals to 2.4, and W1 it will be equals to 185. So 1085. And similarly, W2 also shows reading 185 or 90. So W2 it will be equals to 1085. So we can see here W1 and W2 shows the same readings for the resistive load bank. So that from this W2 and W1 we can calculate the total active power. So total active power it will be equals to W, and this W it is equals to W1 plus W2. So we have to just simply add these two parameters, W1 plus W2, that will be our total active power which is consumed by the load. Okay. After the conduction of practical, we have to calculate the power factor and the total active power which is consumed by the load. So we will towards the calculations. So I have two readings, W1 and W2. 810 and 810. As we had seen that in the practical session, wattmeter shows the same readings for the resistive type of load. So from this one, we have to firstly calculate total power, and second one is the power factor. So firstly, we have to calculate again multiplying factor. This multiplying factor, it is equals to voltage range into current range into power factor divided by full scale deflection. So at the time of practical, I am using the 500 range of the voltmeter. Current range is 10 and power factor for the resistive load is nothing but our 1. And full scale deflection is 2500. We are using the same wattmeters, 2500. So it will be equals to 2. So the multiplying factor of our both wattmeters, it is nothing but 2. So final wattmeter readings, it will be equals to wattmeter reading into multiplying factor. So it will be equals to 810 into 2, and again for here 810 into 2 for the first reading. I am taking the first reading 810 and 810, wattmeter 1 and 2. So simply 810 into 2, it will be equals to 1620 watt. So we have to calculate the total active power. Total active power, it will be equals to W1 plus W2. So simply we have to add this 1620 plus 1620. So it will be equals to 3240 watt, and this is nothing but our total active power. So this is the active power in the three-phase circuit which is consumed by the load. So next we will move towards the power factor. So we have to calculate the power factor, and for this power factor we will go by step by step. So firstly we can calculate. So what is the power factor? This is nothing but your cos phi, and this cos phi equals to question mark. So we have to calculate this cos phi, but as we know that for the resistive type of load, cos phi it will be equals to 1. So when also we had seen the effect of wattmeter readings, the effect of wattmeter readings, effect of power factor on the wattmeter readings, that means whenever we are changing the type of load, the power factor will change with respect to W1 and W2. That means whenever we are connecting the resistive type of load, wattmeter shows the same reading, and from these same readings our power factor should be equals to 1. So we will see our power factor is coming equals to 1 or not. So we will calculate the cos phi. For the cos phi, firstly I am taking the tan phi. It will be equals to root 3. The formula, tan phi equals to root 3 W1 minus W2 upon W1 plus W2. So I have the readings W1 and W2. It will be equals to 1620 minus 1620 divided by again same 1620 plus 1620. So from here we can say 0 divided by 3240. So it will be equals to root 3 into 0. So this tan phi equals to 0. So this tan phi equals to 0. From this one we have to calculate the angle. So this phi it is equals to tan inverse of 0. So this phi is nothing but equals to 90 degrees. And from this 90 we can simply calculate the power factor. So this cos phi, take the cosine angle, therefore cos phi it is equals to cos 90 and it will be equals to 1. So we can say that for the resistive type of load our power factor will be equals to 90 degrees when the wattmeter shows same readings, equal readings, 1620 equals to 1620. So from this one we can conclude that we can measure the three phase power measurement with the help of two wattmeters by the two wattmeter method, that is our total active power W1 plus W2, it will be whatever. And from this one, when resistive load is connected, the wattmeter shows same readings, and for that one, our power factor is nothing but unity. Okay, thank you.